Good morning, students. In today's class of service marketing, we start with a new concept, that is service consumer behavior. In the previous class, we have studied about the service product development, where we have studied where right from the idea generation, business strategy, the service is developed, a form is given to the service, and then the final service offering is made and commercialization of services done. In today's class, we'll be focusing our discussion on service consumer behavior. Here we are discussing consumer behavior from the standpoint of services. The service and goods, they differ, as we have studied earlier in the class, in earlier classes. So in today's class, we'll understand how the behavior of the consumer changes when they buy services. What is the behavior of the customers or consumers when they're buying services? So we'll first understand what is consumer behavior, and then we'll understand how it affects the behavior of the consumers when they are buying services. We'll start with service consumer behavior. Two definitions were given. The first definition that was given was for Blackwell and Milliard. It said that consumer behavior includes all those activities directly involved in obtaining, consuming, and disposing of products and services, including the decision processes that precede and follow these actions. So Blackwell and Milliard, they said that consumer behavior includes all those activities. Those are completely or directly involved in three things: obtaining, consuming, and disposing of the product and services. When we obtain a new product, when product or service, when we consume a new product or service, when we dispose of the product or service, what is the various activities that we go through this, and what is the decision processes that goes in the customer's or consumer's mind preceding or following these actions? This all comes under the purview of consumer behavior. Another definition was given by Belch and Belch. They said that consumer behavior is the process and activities people engage in. It is a process and also a set of activities that people engage in. That means the consumers engage in while they are searching for, selecting, purchasing, using, evaluating, and disposing of products and services so as to satisfy their needs and desires. So they have given a much more detailed definition, and they said that it is not only a process, it also includes the processes, various processes that the people or the consumers, they get into or involved in. What are the processes or the activities they end up involved in? It is searching for the product or service, selecting the product or service, purchasing the product or service, using and evaluating the product and service, and finally disposing the product and service so as to satisfy their needs and desires. So this was the definition that was given by Belch and Belch. Now moving forward, consumer buying behavior refers to the buying behavior of the final consumers who buy the goods and services for their personal consumption. That is the reason they are known as consumer buying behavior. It includes the buying behavior of the final consumers who directly consume the product for their own personal consumption. Okay, this is known as consumer buying behavior. Service marketer need to be able to close the customer gap between expectation and perceptions. When we deal with services, also products, also especially services, the service marketers, they have to be able to close the gap between the expectations of the consumer and the perceptions of the consumers. So this is the gap that happens, and service marketers need to close this customer gap. To achieve this objective, service providers need to understand how customers choose and evaluate their service offerings. So in order to reduce this gap between the expectation and perceptions, they have to achieve this. They have to understand how consumers choose and evaluate the service offering. What are the ways in which the service consumer evaluates and chooses a particular service offering? So this should be done. Then consumers have a difficult time evaluating and choosing services than costs. Obviously, because services are intangible, non-standardized, and partly because consumption is also intertwined with production. So the consumption and production in the consumption happens simultaneously. That is the reason. And since there is heterogeneous, services are heterogeneous, they're intangible. So it is very difficult for the service consumers to evaluate and choose the various services. The study of consumer behavior helps in analyzing different factors that have an influence on the buying decision of the consumers. The study of the consumer gives an idea as to what are the various factors that influence and entice or shape the buying decisions of the consumers. We have to understand what is the thing that triggers the buying decision of the consumers. Once we understand this, we will be able to make our marketing campaigns much more productive, much more efficient, much more effective. So we have to understand what clicks with the customer. We have to understand what are the various decision processes that the consumers go through and what are the various factors that influence their decision processes of the buying decisions of the consumers. This is highly essential for the marketer to know. And if the marketer fail to understand these factors, they would not meet that target. They will not able to meet the targets. They will not be able to satisfy the service consumers properly, and they will not be able to achieve the targets. So we'll understand what are the various factors that affects the consumer behavior in case of services. So there are a number of factors or variables which affect the buying behavior in services. They are divided into certain heads. First is social factors. Second is the cultural factors. Third is the psychological factors. Fourth is the personal factors. And fifth is the economic factors. So these are the various factors that affect the or influence the buying behavior in case of services. Buying behavior of consumers in case of services. So we need to understand all these factors. The marketer needs to have an idea of all these factors so that he will be able to prepare a much more effective and efficient marketing program so as to attract or entice maximum consumers to buy their services. We will discuss each of these factors individually in the later slides, and each of these factors contains various sub-factors that we need to understand the complete factors. So we start with the social factors. Social factors. Under social factors, the first thing that we'll discuss is family. Family is one of the most powerful social factors affecting consumer behavior. It is the main factor that becomes or social factor which affects the consumer behavior, because it is the family who gives the gift shapes to our ideas, the gift shapes to our behavior. So it is one of the most important and powerful social factors affecting the consumer behavior. Family consumption behavior to a large extent depends on the family life cycle. So this, when we say this family is influencing the buying behavior of the service customers, we have to understand that this family, how it influences the buying behavior is to a large extent from the family life cycle. By the help of this family life cycle, if we understand the family life cycle, we'll understand how family impacts the buying behavior of the consumers. The stages of family life cycle includes bachelorhood, newly married, parenthood with growing or grown-up children, post-parenthood, and dissolution. These are the various family life cycle, and we have to understand the family life cycle to understand what is will be the need for the services. For bachelorhood, the services will be different. For post-parenthood, the services will be different. For bachelorhood, the services may be for requirement for people very powerful internet services or the streaming, digital streaming services like Netflix or other things. Because this bachelorhood, the people have much more time. They want much more time for recreation. So their recreation ways, their consumption ways, they may be needing this food delivery services, applications, the Zoom, other transportation services, facilities also they require. Their services also they require. So car rentals and other things are required. But when we move forward, like for post-parenthood, or when the children are grown up, when the people are old, then the services that they require more is like good banking services they require, so that they can get a regular money. They also require good healthcare services that is required for with parenthood, with grown-up children or post-parenthood. So these are the ways the services changes in the various family lifestyle. We have to understand that in order to get an idea about it. Then we have to also see that in family, the knowledge of these stages helps greatly in knowing the dying process. As we have already discussed, this what are the stage in which the person is in the family life cycle helps in knowing their dying process and the requirements, and it helps us to the marketers to make a much more powerful marketing program. Values, tradition, preferences are transmitted from parents to children inherently. Why family is one of the most important social factors is because all the values, the traditions, the preferences are transmitted to the parents, from parents to the children. The children learn from the parents. So it is the reason why family is considered one of the most powerful social factors. Family members constitute the most influential primary reference group. We'll be reading another social factor, that is a reference group. And family is considered as the primary reference group because this is the place where the child's values, traditions, preference, buying behavior, all these are shaped by the family, because the children first learn from their parents. So family forms the most influential primary reference group. Often primary members play a significant role in purchase of a particular service. Similarly, while purchasing a particular service, the family members plays a very important role. I suppose a new or a young investor is investing in mutual funds. He may be significantly influenced by the father or somebody in his family who has proper knowledge or experience in buying of mutual funds. So the family members play a very significant role in purchase of many services. Now, coming to another kind of social factor that is important we should understand is the reference group. Philip Kotler stated the definition of reference group. He says a person's reference group consists of all the groups that have direct face-to-face or indirect influence on the person's attitudes or behavior. So reference group, when we say reference group of a person, it includes all the various groups of people with whom the person is directly or indirectly influenced, and this influences on the person's attitude and the behavior. Depending upon the group, his attitude and behavior changes. So this is not the reference group. This definition was given by Philip Kotler. Therefore, there are certain groups to which people look to guide their behavior. So they considered the behavior of the group. They look up to the group, they admire the group, they want to be a part of the group, so they want to imitate the group. And their behavior is properly shaped by this reference group. These references groups may guide the choice of a service, but not necessarily the brand. But sometimes it also affects the brand. Suppose you are interested to invest in a particular or take the service of a particular car rental services. Then you can do one thing is that you can ask your senior or a particular reference group, maybe your senior in your office, you may take his exam help, or if he's a friend who is very, you consider him that he is gone to various places, so he has much more information and experience in that field, so you may ask him for what is a better car rental service. So the reference group helps in the choice of the service, and also sometimes, not necessarily brand, but sometimes also the brand of the service also is influenced by the reference group. Now next, the peer group or peer pressure has generally observed to play an important role in the purchase of credit card, banking and insurance instrument, etc. Like suppose you are working in an office and everybody has a particular company's credit card, or they are included, interested in a particular recreation activity. So this peer group or peer pressure forces an individual to enter or buy certain groups or buy certain service products in order to be a part of the group, in order to see themselves similar to the reference group. The knowledge of reference group behavior helps in not only offering substitutes but also in pricing and positioning them. Why this knowledge of reference group is required? Because it helps is the not only in offering substitute, if they are not interested in this, what is the other substitute? Not only offering the substitute but also in pricing and positioning them. We can also price and position the goods and services by looking into the reference groups of the people. Now, in social factors, there is a third kind of factor that helps, it comes under social factor that influences the consumer behavior or the buying behavior in services. That is roles and status. What is the role of the person? What is the status of the person? It has an impact on the buying behavior of the consumers in case of services. We'll understand that a person is influenced by the role that he holds in the society. Every person in the society has a certain role that he performs. He may be a father, he may be a manager, he may be a son. So depending upon the roles, he has certain behavior that he has to perform. And each role carries a particular status. Each role, the role of a father, there's a particular status attached to it. The role of a manager or a senior has a particular status to it. So all these roles, they come with status. So these roles are also accompanied by the status. If a person is in a high ranking position, his buying behavior will be influenced largely by status. Suppose you are the manager of a big company. So the kind of services you will be using will be of a higher value because you want to be part of that higher position of services. Suppose you go for your beautification, or you want to go for salon services, or you want to go for a salon or spa services. So if you're in high position, then your buying gear will be influenced accordingly. You will be taking the help or taking the service of a best spa, very costly spa. But when you are an employee and you don't have that much position, and if you want to take the services of a spa, you will be looking for a more affordable spa that will be catering to your needs. So depending upon the role and status of the person, the buying behavior of the service changes. Now, in roles and status, the marketer should also try to associate the service offering and brands with roles, with specific roles and status. So it is the role of the marketer. Why we are studying? Because it is the role of the marketer to associate these roles and status and make similar offering, service offering and brands so that people will buy. So for a spa, they will be having very beautiful high quality services. Also, they will be having affordable services. So though as a marketer, you need to understand you have to give service offering for the various price points for the people from the various roles and status. For example, already an example is given. For example, a person who is the CEO in a company will buy according to his status, while a staff or employee of the same company will have different buying pattern. As we have discussed earlier, the example of a spa. Similarly, we can take any other example. Like suppose we are taking any tourism services. We want to go for a outing outside of the city or outside the state. The kind of tourism services will be taken by a CEO will be different from the staff or employee working in the same company. Okay, so these are all the social factors that help to guide the buying behavior in case of services. Now we will understand the second factor. Apart from social factor, the second factor that affects the buying behavior in services, that is the cultural factors. Under cultural factors also, there are certain sub factors that we need to know in order to get a pure or complete idea about how culture plays an important role in shaping or influencing the consumer buying behavior in case of services. The first thing under cultural factor is nothing but the culture. Culture is a very complex belief of human behavior, and it includes the human society, the roles that the society plays, the behavior of the society, its values, customs, traditions, all these things are included in the culture. It's a very complex term, okay? And it includes the complete behavior of the society, the various values, customs, traditions, beliefs, all these things are included in the culture. Children acquire from their environment a set of beliefs, values, and customs which constitute culture. So these children, they get the culture from their parents, from the environment that the parents prefer. And this environment is nothing but a set of beliefs, values, customs, traditions that they're born into. So when they grow in that particular set of beliefs, values, customs, traditions, it forms the part of the culture of the child. These beliefs, values, customs go deeper and deeper as a person grows. So it gets imbibed in the, internalized by the children, and this deepens or grows deeper and deeper as the person grows. Now, in culture, apart from culture, there are various subcategories within a culture that can be identified based on religion, age, gender, occupation, social class, geographical location, etc. All these things, subcategories of culture, they also influence the buying behavior in case of services. So suppose we say, take the example of religion as a part of culture. So there are certain services, there's certain things that the people from particular religion do that the people from other religion do not do. Since, for example, the people from Hindu religion, they want to take the services to go to their holy places, whereas Muslim people would like to go to Mecca. This is their holy place. So the services that they take or avail depending upon the culture. Similarly, upon the gender or age also. Suppose age we have discussed. Let us take the example of gender. The kind of services that a person or a lady will take will be different from a male person that he takes when he goes to a spa. Maybe the kind of salon they go, maybe the kind of haircut they are interested in. So, or maybe in banking services, the kind of credit cards or the kind of loans or the kind of this bank account that will be, savings bank account will be open. There will be certain special privileges for this woman, ladies gender, whereas no such big facilities are given for this male gender. So according to the gender also, the kind of the buying behavior in terms of services also differs. So all these examples, religion, age, gender, occupation, social class, geographical location, etc., they all form the part of the culture of the part of the culture. Culture need to be examined as it is very important factor that influences the consumer behavior. Why this is important? Because it highly affects or influences the consumer behavior. So we need to have a deep and thorough understanding of the culture. Then comes, the marketer must be aware of this relevant cultural aspects, and the marketing program should be designed accordingly. Why the marketer needs to understand the culture and what are the various subcategories of a culture? Because they need to form relevant marketing programs. They can design, they can come up with relevant marketing programs so that they will be able to entice more customers to use their services. So that is the reason they need to understand the various aspects of culture and various subcategories of culture, because they immensely impact the consumer behavior or the buying behavior in case of services. Now coming to in cultural factors, another factor we need to study subfactor, that is subculture. Each culture consists of many subcultures. So culture is the main, and the under it comes the subculture. Each subculture provides a more specific identification of members belonging to it. The subculture gives much more finer, detailed, and specific identification of the members that are part of the particular subculture. Subculture includes nationality, religion, racial groups, geographical regions. So these are the various subcategories of culture, which we have understood earlier. The nationality of the person, the racial group, the religion, the geographical region, etc. These are the various subcultures which impacts the buying behavior of the services. Service and marketing programs should be prepared in the light of subcultures to tailor their needs. So each subculture is a much more finer, detailed identification of the members belonging to it. And accordingly, the marketer must be able to make these tailor-made services for the specific subculture so as to reach and tap the target market. So this is highly required. So when we say nationality, every nation has its own unique culture that shapes and controls the behaviors of its citizens. So the culture, subculture, Indian culture really different from American culture different from Japanese. So let us give an example. For example, Indian culture, American culture, Japanese culture, Chinese culture, all these cultures are different. Similarly, when we take the example of religion, every religion has its own terms of values, rules, rituals, procedures that they impacts on its followers. So each religion has their own beliefs, own set of rituals, own set of values or procedures that they need to undergo in order to be a part of that religion. So let us take an example, Christians, Hindus, Muslims, Buddhists, etc. These religions influence the food preference, the clothing choice, the career aspirations, and overall pattern of life. Let me give an example of food preference and with respect to religion. Like there are certain products that are not consumed by Hindus and there are certain products that are not consumed by Muslims. Like Hindus do not consume beef and Muslims do not consume pork. So that is the reason companies like McDonald's, when they opened their branches in India, they studied the culture and subculture of India. They understood that under the subculture, religion plays a very important part in the buying behavior of the services, the products and services. And they understood that in order to entice people to buy from McDonald's, they need to make some changes in their menu. That is the reason they remove beef and pork and ham all from their menu. And they start and they shaped the menu of the Indian McDonald's as per the palate of the Indian people, as per the religious belief of the Indian people. Now they are giving this paneer, aloo tikki and other chicken variety of burgers and other things. So McDonald's changed their complete menu in order to enter into India. So we can understand how religion plays a very important role and how the marketer or big company, marketers of very big companies, they take into account every aspect of culture and subculture in order to promote their products in the market. Similarly, the clothing style and the cultural career aspirations and the overall pattern, how they live, are completely different as per the religion, different religions. Then we come to the racial groups. The racial groups have their own cultural values, norms, standards, habits, etc. that govern their overall response towards the company's services. And when we say racial group, they have their own norms, own standards and habits. Let me give you an example. Similarly, like we have various divisions in the racial groups, the particular, like Jats have their particular norms, habits. So these racial groups, they form a part of this subculture and they have a strong bearing on the buying behavior in case of services. Similarly, each geographic region represents a specific culture and differ in terms of needs, preference, habits, usage rates, etc. are determined by regional climate and culture. Like for the geographical region, suppose the preference and the needs will be changing. Like people will be buying different products as per the geographical region they are present. So this geographical region also being a part of the subculture, they shape the buying behavior in case of services, they influence the buying behavior of the services. That is the reason the marketer needs to have an in-depth knowledge of the various factors and sub-factors of the sub-factor that is existing in the market in order to tap the market well, in order to target the consumers well. So this is the reason it is required. So, and now comes to the last thing, that is the social class. These are also for part of the cultural factors. Then we say social class. Social classes are relatively homogeneous and enduring divisions in a society which are hierarchical, ordered, and whose members have or share similar values, interests, and behavior. So people belonging to a particular social class will have same beliefs, will have same interests, are homogeneous in nature. This is the reason the society is further divided into various social classes. This definition was given by Philip Kotler. Each and every society across the globe has various forms of social classes. The social classes is not just determined by the income, but also other factors such as occupation, family background, education, residence location. All these things determine the social class. Like if we divide by income, we will not only from income, from occupation, you may be a different, there's a social class of doctors will be different, a particular family background, education, all MBAs will be different, they will be having a special social class, all particular residence or a location, like people from Barampur will be having a different social class. So location also, the kind of residence you are having, the family background, all these things impact the social class. And then every social class has its cultures that affects the behavior of its members. So why this social class is important? Because this social class has its own culture which affects the behavior of its members. And each of the social class differ in their dress, speech patterns, recreational preferences, social statuses, value orientation, etc. This way, the one social class is different from the other. Let me give you an example of social status, like how they dress. If people are from a group of CEOs, so their recreation facilities will be different, their social statuses will be different, their way of dressing will be different. And another social class may be a set of workers, blue collar jobs workers, and they will be working in factories. So their recreational preferences, what they want to do for their recreation, their social status, so that will be different. So the social classes are different in terms of their speech patterns, dress patterns, the recreational preferences, social status, value rates, how much value they attach to a particular service. So this changes. That is the reason we have to understand this social class as a part of the cultural factors, and we have to understand how the social class affects or impacts the buying behavior in case of services. With references to India, on the basis of income number or status in the society, we can identify three social classes like upper class, middle class, or low class. If we take income or status in the society as the viewpoint of dividing the society into various subclasses, into social classes, then we can say it is divided into upper class, middle class, or the lower class. So the buying pattern is supposed to take the example of recreational preferences. The upper class of recreational preferences will be different. The lower class recreational facilities will be different. Suppose the upper class for their recreation, they want to go for a foreign tour, or they want to get into some new thing or a language. But for a lower class, the recreation may be going for a movie or going for a mela, attending a mela or a religious place. So for recreation, then for a lower class may be different. So the social class plays a very important role, and it shapes the buying behavior of the services, of the customers in case of services. That is the reason we need to understand social class as a part of the cultural factor and how it affects the buying behavior in case of services. So these are the two factors that we have studied today. Please go through the factors. If you have certain doubts, contact me. No need to panic. Stay at home, prepared. And finally, thank you for your attention.